Sometimes a musician comes along who is so well respected that when their life is cut short tragically, they are instantly etched into the annals of music history. And other times, an equally talented musician is somehow forgotten to time. That was the case with Eddie Costa. He was highly successful, loved by his peers, and yet for some reason, he's all but forgotten today. So I'd like to take a little look at the life and the music of Eddie Costa, a vibraphonist and pianist whom you should know. Eddie was born in rural Pennsylvania in 1930 and started doing paid gigs on the piano from the early age of 15. Along the way, he taught himself how to play the vibraphone. At the age of 24, he started making his first professional recordings. Here's a clip of him playing vibes with the Sal Salvador Quintet, which, by the way, had the legendary Joe Morello on drums. In 1956, Costa recorded his first album as a leader. His piano playing was already revealing itself to be sure-minded and strong, as evidenced by this opening track, Fascinating Rhythm. The clarity of his playing shows just how good of a musician he was, and he started getting work in the recording studios of New York City. Eddie was a complete musician who could read anything, improvise on anything, and do it on multiple instruments. In 1957, he recorded his second album, the Eddie Costa Quintet, with Phil Woods, Art Farmer, Teddy Kotick, and Paul Motion. On this album, he played mostly piano, but he did record a few vibraphone solos. Here's one of them. It's a clip of In Your Own Sweet Way. And in this clip, you can really hear his unique style and phrasing, which, in my opinion, doesn't really sound like any of the other vibraphonists of the time. His most famous album as a leader is probably 1958's Guys and Dolls Like Vibes. This album featured Bill Evans, Wendell Marshall, and Paul Motion. Check out these swinging lines from his solo on the album opener, Guys and Dolls. Still only one dimension of Costa's incredible musicianship. Check out the dark and almost avant-garde approach he takes to the blues in 1959's House of the Blue Lights. Now, to me, that recording is evidence that Costa was really developing a strong and unique identity. But unfortunately, it was his last recording as a leader. One night in July 1962, he crashed his car on the West Side Highway in Manhattan near 72nd Street, and he left behind his wife and four children. In the aftermath of his death, the jazz world convened for one of the biggest, most selective, and best-planned memorial concerts in his honor. A live recording of the event was released on record featuring Clark Terry and Coleman Hawkins. Today, more than 60 years later, Eddie Costa's family still celebrates his memory on their Facebook page. Eddie was a unique voice whose music still sounds fresh and inspiring today. So thank you, Eddie, for the music, and thank you for watching.